Hello. So today we will see one Java program for vehicle operations. So vehicles has a different examples like bicycle, car, bike, and they are having common facility like change gear, then increase the speed and apply brakes. So in this program we are making one interface, and in interface we are declaring some abstract methods and we are overriding in the class. So let's see the program. So in this program I want to use some packages. So I have used first line as import, in which I am importing java.io for input output operations. So after this I have declared interface name is vehicle, and in that I have written three abstract methods. First is change gear to shift the gear, second speed up, so using that we can increase the speed of the vehicle, and third is apply brake to decrease the speed. So in all three methods I am passing parameter as a integer a. So that we can access in the method. So after interface I have declared a class bicycle, which are inheriting from the base class vehicle. So in Java we have to use implements keywords for inheritance. So in that I have used two data members, speed and gear. So initially that values are zero. So after that I have override three methods. First method is change gear. So I am passing parameter as new gear, and I am assigning to the gear data member. So in this way that gear can be changed from 1 to 2, 2 to 3, like that. Then next method, speed up, to increase the speed. So in that I am passing that by how much unit we have to increase the speed, and then I am adding that increment to the initial speed. Speed is equal to speed plus increment. So if initial speed is 10 and increment is 5, then now vehicle speed is 15. Then next, apply brake. So I am overriding this method, and in that when we apply brake we are decrementing that speed. So I am passing that decrement data member, that parameter, and I am writing speed is equal to speed minus decrement. So if initial speed is 20 and my decrement value is 5, then now vehicle speed will be 15, like this. Then print states, in which I am printing that speed of that vehicle and gear, what is the gear position. So that I am printing using system.out.println. In that speed colon, that message will be displayed, and then actual speed, that data member value will be displayed. Then gear colon and gear, in on which gear that vehicle is running, that will be displayed. So same for bike also. So I have written bike class, and I am using implements keywords to use inheritance, and I am inheriting from the vehicle base class. Then same two data members, speed and gear, and Again, I have overridden three methods: change gear, speed up, and apply brakes. So same logic of previous bicycle class. So for change gear, I am taking input as a parameter from the main function, and I am assigning to the gear. For speed up, I am taking increment as a parameter, and I am adding to the current speed. For apply brake, I am taking a decrement parameter from the main, and I am reducing the speed minus decrement. So using this, speed will be decrement, that is apply brake, and after that we can print the state of the bike on how much speed that bike is running and on which gear that bike is running using system.out.println. So here system is the class, and then println is the method. So here in double quote speed colon, that message will be displayed as it is, and what is the actual speed of that bike, that will be displayed, then gear colon as message, and gear number on which that bike is running, that will be displayed. Then this is the main method. So here that main method, I have written one class, that is GFG. Any class name you can give. So here I have to create the object. So first object I have created of bicycle class. So bicycle, this is the class, and this is the object name bicycle. And in Java we have to use a new keyword to create the object. So this is the syntax to create a object in Java. So here bicycle is the object name. So in object oriented programming, when we have to call any method, we have to call with the object name. So here I am using object name bicycle dot change gear, and I am in that I am passing 2 as a gear. So when this line is executed, then change gear of bicycle class method will be executed. So this code will be executed, and now new gear is 2, so now gear will be assigned as 2. So on second gear my bicycle is running. Next again it will come back to the main, then next line bicycle dot speed up 3. So here bicycle is the object and speed up, that is the method, and in that we have passed 3. So again it will call speed up method of bicycle class, and in that 3 is we have passed. So initially speed is 0, now on speed 3 our bicycle is running. Next again it will come back to the main and apply brake, and in brake apply brake we have passed 1. So again it will call print states of bicycle apply brake of bicycle class, and it will decrement by 1. So initially our bicycle was running on 3 speed, so it will decrement by 1. Now speed is 2. So all of you getting, our bicycle is running on second gear and speed is 2. Next it will display this message system.out.println. Using that we can display message bicycle's present state. So after that we are calling print states method using object bicycle. So bicycle dot print states, this is the syntax, and it will call print states of bicycle class. So it will display speed colon, now our bicycle is running on second, that speed is 2 and gear is second. So it will display speed colon 2 and gear colon 2. So you can check that output also here. Bicycle present state and speed is 2 and gear is 2. Next, after bicycle, I have created object of bike class. So bike, this is the class, and small bike is the object of that class. And a new keyword is used to create the object. After that, again, if you have to call the methods of the bike class, then we have to use object dot and then method name. So here bike is the object dot and then method name change gear. So we have passed one first gear, so it will, when this line is executed, execution, this will execute the change gear method of the bike class which we have overridden from the interface. So in that we have passed one, and now our bike is running on the first gear. New gear is assigned to the gear, so now our bike is running on the first gear. Next, speed up. So in speed up we have passed 4, so it will call speed up method of the bike class, and initially speed is 0 and increment we have passed 4. So now our bike is running on first gear and speed is 4. Next, apply brake. So when we apply brake and in that we pass that 3 units, then it will call apply brakes method, and in that we have passed 3 as a decrement value. So initially our speed of that bike is 4 minus 3, that is the decrement value. Now our bike speed is 1. So now our bike is running on first gear and speed is also 1. So after that we have printed this message bike present state using system.out.println. So this is displayed here as it is. Next, we have called print states method. So it will call print states and it will display speed as a message and actual speed of that vehicle, that is 1, and gear colon and bike is running on first gear. So it will be displayed here. So this is the 5th assignment of object oriented programming. Please like my channel, subscribe and share. This is Rahul Raskar from Parikrama College of Engineering, Kasti. Thank you very much. If you want more video like this, please write in comment on which topic you want next video.